Here, this is what the biggest limitation here is, that is, it will not serve as a substitute for management. Cost accounting just reports cost data, but management accounting does what? It does something more than that. See here, management accounting not only reports financial and cost data, but also analyzes and interprets the data. Now, financial accounting is all about historical data they collect, and then they go with what? The past and the previous. Hello everybody, a warm welcome to One and All. I'm Abhilash Chandra from the Department of Commerce and Management in Vidyashram First Grade College, the Temple of Excellence. Welcome to all the students for the short questions, what you people can expect in the first chapter. Now, Vidyashram is the only college which does everything for the students, and now we are doing something called the short. What else you can actually expect from any other college? Let me just go with this. The unit one which I'll be doing it, I'll tell you, it's all about the theory which you will be getting in part A, part B, as well as in part C. So what are the questions, how the questions are going to come in the main examination of ACMA, that is Advanced Cost and Management Accounting for the 6th semester BCom. Let's go with this. Now, when we go with this last day, last show, we are supposed to know that how the question paper pattern is set. Now, when we understand the question paper pattern, the theory questions can actually come in the 15 marks as well as 10 marks as well as the 5 marks. So here what exactly we go is, the theory 15 to 10 marks is what I'm going to cover in the first chapter. You may expect a 15 marks as well as a 10 marks from the first chapter itself. So the question will be like this: explain the nature, objectives and scope of management accounting. So here, management accounting is what the introduction chapter which they go with. So they're gonna ask you a question which is a sure question called as, what is management accounting? So please prepare for what exactly management accounting is really for. Then you need to go with something like definition of management accounting, and you can actually write more about it according to O'Donnell, what exactly management accounting is, according to the London Cost and Management Accounting, what is management accounting, according to the Indian accounting standards, what exactly management accounting is. You can actually go with that. Then the things are nature, objective and scope. If you go with it, you break the question like 5 marks for nature, 5 marks for objective, or 5 marks for your scope. That is how you need to break the questions. Next is, what does management accounting? See the question, this is what the question you are supposed to prepare for. What is management accounting? Explain the difference between management accounting and cost accounting. The same type of a question you may also get, that is, explain the difference between management accounting and financial accounting. So you have two 15 marks question which can come like this, that is, explain the differences between, or you are supposed to go with, explain what exactly the nature, objective and scope of management accounting. So only two questions if you prepare in the first chapter, you may get a question for 15 marks. So please be ready with that. And here you have one more thing, that is the 5 marks question, limitations of management accounting. So if you go with this, limitations of management accounting, it is again 5 marks. So this chapter 15, 10, or you also can expect for 5. So totally, if you go with that, understand 30 marks theory here only you have actually got. So this is how you are supposed to prepare. So I have given you the meaning here. The Institute of Cost and Management Accounting in London, what exactly they have said. I've given you the objectives here. Now you are supposed to go with each and every point and then explain it at least 5 to 6 sentences. What exactly you mean by data feeding? What do you mean by planning in management accounting? Elimination of guesswork? Why management accounting is actually introduced? What exactly the objectives of management accounting is? So here, if you go with the meaning, like half of the page, and then you write each and every point, like 10 points, and then explain 5 to 6 points, and then go with the one more thing, that is called the differences. Now, when you go with the differences, please do understand that what you are supposed to do is, firstly give introduction to that particular question. Say example, they would have given you a question: what is management accounting? Explain the difference between cost accounting and management accounting. First you give introduction saying that management accounting is defined as what exactly management accounting is. Then you come with what is management accounting differences, and then what is the cost accounting differences. So you can give differences like this, that is cost accounting here and management accounting here, or vice versa. Whatever you feel like actually going with, you can go with the management accounting and cost accounting. At least I'm telling you 10 differences is what you are supposed to quote. So here I have done this. Now I have taken cost accounting here and then the management accounting. So when I go with the cost accounting, the emergence of cost accounting is mainly due to what? That is the limitations of financial accounting. So what is the difference between here is the emergence of management accounting is because of the limitations of cost accounting. That means what? This is something which people need to know what exactly happens in their own company. So you can go with the differences. Here I have given 3 differences for you people. Next here, still more 3 differences here I have given. Now, if you understand that F part here, cost accounting just reports cost data, but management accounting does what? It does something more than that. See here, management accounting not only reports financial and cost data, but also analyzes and interprets the data. That will analyze and then interpret what exactly the need of these accountancies are all about. So that is what the difference is about cost and management accounting. See here also I have given like 4, totally 3 plus 3 plus 4, in the sense 10 differences we have already gone with. So that is how you will be getting 15 marks. So 5 marks for the meaning definition and then 10 marks for the differences. So you get 15 marks here very clearly. Next is differences between financial and management accounting. Here see, I have given you one more kind of a trending, that is here you can go with the basis, on what basis they are actually being differentiated. You go with financial accounting, you go with management accounting. That means very simple. If you know what is management accounting, cost and financial, you can go with the differences. So learn this. This is very, very important. Then you can go with what exactly is the difference about it. Now, financial accounting is all about historical data they collect, and then they go with what? The past and the previous. But here in management accounting, it is all about current and future. So this is what the differences which you people need to go with. Now here, say example, user of report. Who are the people who will use financial accounting? Who are the people who use management accounting? For the financial accounting, it is the outsiders. They are the person who actually use financial accounting to see what exactly the company is doing. But management accounting is for the insiders. So we call this, them as like simple, financial accounting for the external, management accounting for the internal. So this is how you are supposed to go with the differences here. Now here, focuses on nature of report, verification of report. Now verification of report, if you go with financial accounting, they go with what? The CPA audited by whom? CPA. But here when you go with the management accounting, no, the CPA will not come here. It is no independent audits they'll actually go with it. So here what exactly it is? Now management accounting is only for us. And management accounting is also called as managerial accounting. So don't get confused about it. Oh, I studied management accounting, but they have given managerial accounting. So both are same. This is how you are supposed to write. Next one we have is limitations. See, limitations can come for 10 marks as well as 5 marks. If it comes for 10 marks, you are supposed to explain each of them. But if it comes for like 5 marks, you can only write the points that what are the limitations of management accounting. Say here, limitations of basic records. Now basic records, there is a problem in management accounting. Lack of knowledge of related discipline, because it's a very new subject, so people don't know how exactly they are supposed to use management accounting. Provision of only data but not decisions. So data we will analyze but will not be taking the decisions based on the management accounting. Not a substitute for management. So here, this is what the biggest limitations here is, that is it will not serve as a substitute for management. And next one is persistence of intuitive decision making. So here, decisions and the persistence of intuitive is all what the management accounting limitations are. So if it is for 5 marks, you just need to go with 5 points. If it has come for 10 marks, you are supposed to explain what each and everything here we have actually written for you people. So here I have explained each and every point here. Please do take the notes of Vidyasham and you can actually get 80 on 18 AC MA. So these are the things which I have for you people. And what is that you should do is very simple. Understand the concept. Knowledge is everything, and that is what Vidyashram people are very good with when they render it to the people for free. So this is what we are supposed to go with. The first chapter I have given you a complete pack saying that these are the questions which can come. In the next session, I'm going to teach you about the unit 2 and then we'll complete the entire syllabus. Thank you so much. I'll see you when I see you.